Is it okay to take back a cheating ex? Some say forgiveness is a sign of weakness, that it makes you a pushover. But in a world today with all the hate and the self-justification of revenge, we could argue that it makes you an even stronger or more mature person to forgive someone when you've been wronged. The term forgive and forget is where I disagree. And that's why I say going back to your ex after they've cheated is a big mistake. Forgetting in the sense of moving on with your life would make that way of thinking acceptable. But forget is often understood as pretend it never happened. Most people could forgive the drive-through employee that sucks at their job, but that doesn't mean if you open a fast food restaurant, you're gonna hire them. Life experience comes with time, and life lessons usually come the hard way. They often suck. I've never learned a valuable life lesson in making $1 million without leaving the couch. But I've learned about losing family members. I've learned about being betrayed, and I've learned what it's like to be laid off from my job. I've said it before many times, that we're the only ones that dictate our self-worth. We determine how much we value ourselves. Now others will try to put a label on us and tell us who we are, but they're only right if we allow them to be. A relationship needs trust. Two people that value their partner and their relationship, and if one person is willing to break that trust, they value you much less than you valued them. And worse yet, they value you much less than you value yourself. They'll tell you it was just a mistake, but mistakes are often made by overlooking or forgetting something, and they didn't forget they were in a relationship. And if they overlooked you, that should be the last mistake you ever allow them to make at your expense. You deserve better than that, and you can't settle for less, because if you do, where does it end? We all have this criteria when we're single about what kind of person we're attracted to, what kind of things we can accept, and what kind of things we can't. It's not our fault. We're either into them or we aren't. But we invest that time getting to know someone, building a bond with them. We get comfortable with them. And when the realization creeps in that it isn't going to work, we tend to settle for less by justifying their actions for them. We convince ourselves that it was just a mistake, everybody makes mistakes, or I'm sure it won't happen again. If this never happened, we would still be happy, or I'm sure they've learned their lesson, we could just move past this, it'll make our relationship stronger. But they haven't. They haven't learned their lesson. I talked about life lessons I've needed to learn to make me stronger. When I acted like a shithead in school, I got punched in the face. When I touched a hot stovetop, I burned my hand. When they cheat on the relationship, they lose the relationship. And losing the relationship isn't to spite them. It's to empower you. They need to learn this lesson the hard way, and you need somebody that doesn't need to learn that lesson, or that already has. Like, I know it feels like you're being punished by losing a relationship when you did nothing wrong, but you need to look at it more as you gaining an opportunity to find the right relationship without wasting more time. Look, I'll say this. I spent a year and a half in a relationship with someone that cheated within the first 3 months. My response was revenge. I cheated on her for cheating on me. Then I thought about how much respect I lost for her when she did that to me, and how I thought she was a terrible person. Then I realized I became just as bad as her. I devalued myself by staying with her after that, and even more so by doing the same thing to her. Now, two wrongs don't make a right, but I still wasted another year in that relationship, until she left me for someone else. And as much as I can laugh about that now, at the time it was devastating. Not being broken up with so much as the fact that I took all that shit for all that time and still got kicked to the curb. I lowered my own self-worth so much in that time to accommodate the way I let her disrespect me and the relationship that eventually to her, I was just worthless. And that's on me. There's somebody out there for everyone, and I truly believe that. And nobody is perfect in the technical sense. But you will find somebody that is perfect in your eyes. Their flaws won't bother you because you won't even notice them. You'll acknowledge the bond you have with them and be loyal to that by instinct alone. Look, I could talk for hours, and at the end of the day, the decisions you make are still your decisions. just like your partner's decisions were theirs to make as well. Hopefully this video gave you some form of clarity or reassurance. If it did, I'd really appreciate it if you subscribe to this channel. I make motivational videos like this all the time, and I'd love to have you join the rest of us in moving forward toward better relationships and a better life. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys soon.